Game? Sound? Sound. What's up? Hey everybody. How you doing? Game is only 120 hours long. It's only if that's the time you're spending with it. 210, I think, was the count the first time, and we didn't quite do everything. 210, and that didn't include Hearts of Stone, Blood and Wine at the time. Not at all. Get into trouble every 100 yards. I'm straight. So yeah, 8 during the break. Moving to coffee. I'm gonna raffle off a couple mugs. A couple of the year one mugs. If you haven't seen them, I don't want to lift it up over the computer too much here. Turn it and spill it. But these are the engraved mugs that C-Star and Kim had made. I'm going to raffle two of them off to subscribers during the stream. The raffle, the draw will be at the end, but you can use the command, the mug me command, at any point. If you're a Game Wisp subscriber and you don't already have a mug, I'd love to see everybody have one in the end, but anyways, use the exclamation mark mug me command. You'll get entered. You don't have to be here at the drawing. So, on the hunt for better gear. Dragoon, taking a break from RE6. Welcome, how you doing? Geralt, you want to go down without going too far? Thank you. Ow! The only streamed Dragoon, the only one I've ever played and streamed is 4, and I realize it's a different one. As much as people love it, it's pretty different from the rest of them, isn't it? Never played the classic ones. I don't feel like I might struggle with them too, but been encouraged to play them. Maybe the remakes would be good. Was gonna fast travel up that way. Should I fast travel up to the mill? Or is this one marked as the mill? I see bees! KIG, it's alright. No, most people will not subscribe, and that's just fine. You certainly don't need to do anything else other than just be here and enjoy it and hang out. No, don't feel you ever need to do that. Please don't feel you ever need to do that. Yes, I want to do some things for subscribers. And some things will be subscriber only for that reason. It's not meant to leave people out. It's meant to thank people for doing that too. And I realize that you want to, and that's awesome. So thank you for that. But it shouldn't ever feel like something you need to do. It really shouldn't. As I can't control that, but having everybody here is what makes it so awesome. Having people who financially support the stream makes things much more long-term viable. But that's not what makes it awesome. That is awesome, but what makes it awesome is just the whole everybody here, all of you here, all the time. There's no substitute for that. That comes through PayPal. You're already doing the best part. Nice scarecrow. Still picking up junk, because I'll need every bit of coin I can scratch together for now. Won't be sitting pretty for a while. Now, check out the house. It's up here, the mill. See Gwent cards. Take them. David Liam, welcome back. Alright. We're headed north, but on which side of the water? Oh, wrong side of town. Go up this way. But I want to be on the other side of the water, right? Go north up here. I realize most of you don't know what I'm babbling about. We were talking about going for some Witcher swords. We got one of the Viper sword diagrams. And the next part, and to find Colgrim's body, the Witcher who was accused of kidnapping and killing a child, even though it was drowners who did it. Who's tortured to death before that information made it into the proper hands. But we're going to find Colgrim's body. Hopefully find some more Witcher gear in the process. And of course, without the HUD and the map, navigation takes some extra work. And it's not my strong suit anyways. We're heading in this general direction though, and I'll have to check the map again before we get much closer to it. I can't remember precisely what our destination is. Even if I spotted it from a distance, wouldn't know it. Yeah, see, I almost crossed the water, and I didn't need to. We just need to head north. It could be those right there. What do you know? What do you know? Chatty's still on the fritz here. Chatty has had no idea all night if the stream is up or not. So if you've been here since the beginning tonight, which is not that long yet, 7 hours, how is everyone holding up? I realize for some of you it's the middle of the night or the early morning tomorrow already. For me, it's only 8 o'clock. Got the whole night ahead. I'm woefully under-geared right now.
I have my eye on you, Yodling.
What do you want?
Yordling?
Look at that armor.
I said Novigrad.
The Emperor shall guide us straight to Novigrad.
Not that same point? No. I went right up the shore, completely past what I thought I was heading for. It'll be challenging getting in there. Yeah, we're still level 2. We're gonna have to do a couple of quests just to crack level 3. There's not a lot of experience in The Witcher from killing things, or is there none at all? Trivial amount. Dogs or ghouls?
Ghouls.
Wait, how are we doing? We're gonna run out of inventory room. We're gonna be overburdened soon enough. We gotta get somewhere, sell this crap, buy some other things that we need, craft better gear ASAP. Novo, you just found out you don't work tomorrow? All happy on the couch. Just chillin'. Hopefully these aren't owl ghouls. Attacking!
Message coming in.
Hey, Jackmaster. How are you
Passing
doing?
Through.
Thank you for the host.
Ghoul
Welcome.
Nest. Ought to just destroy it.
I don't have bombs. What were the bombs that I had in... Oh, that was just the tutorials. The only time I ever had bombs was in the tutorial. Whoops. I can make something. Will that work? Will salmon work? I mean, it's not grape shot. Hopefully it'll work. Why did one just pop up if the nest is destroyed? We box them. Not if we get staggered like that. Down to the road. It's kind of walled in. Looks like it's walled in. Where we're going might be on the outside of the wall. Walled in. I'm going everywhere but there at the moment. I start on the coffee. Okay, now I actually I know where we're at. I recognize it. I know some of what's coming up. Awesome. Unsurprisingly, there will be wraiths in the graveyard. Yeah, and wraiths inside.
Humming. Place of power. It's gotta be.
I'm shocked, I tell you, shocked! Nice. Good job, Wraith. Jesse! I look like the Witcher. I'll take that. You should see the picture that Alex did. Alex Obscura did an incredible picture on my birthday last year of Geralt, or me. And which is it? Is it me or is it Geralt? I'm not sure which. But it was awesome. It was a little bit of both. I have a link to that here, do we? I mean, it's up. It's up on, at least it's up on Twitter. I think you'd have to dig through it and find a link. You and Crunch Ward just finished a wee stream. Almost 3:30, heading for bed soon. I'm gonna watch for a bit. Awesome, glad you're here. Thank you. Going in the middle of the night before bed. Hope the Wii stream was good, too. Shall we go in? Question came up, what would you change about the game? I'm not sure I would really change much of anything. There's a few things that I feel need fixing, and I guess that's what I would change. Little things like the hitboxes on lootables and interactables. Even though they have two different movement styles, and one of them's supposed to be snappy, Geralt does a lot of backpedaling and stumbling, and sometimes, stumbling's the wrong word, but you'll be trying to activate something. You could really fuss with it sometimes. It could be a lootable, it could be something on a wall. Getting the hitbox that you need can be more work than it should be. So that's one little thing. Yeah, you found it. Thank you. That sword's better than the one we're using. I should have looked through the swords I've been picking up, even though most of them are just rusty blades. But yeah, there you go. Every little bit helps until we get something better. Steel. Good for wraiths.
I have detected a signal embedded in the static.
Holo Cherry, thank you for the follow. Welcome. Welcome aboard. Did I say that wrong? Please let me know if I did. Some welcomes in chat. Something I needed to find outside before coming in.
I have detected a signal embedded in the static.
Rudy! Rudy, thank you for the follow. All aboard! Welcome! Welcome aboard the Starship Chaos. Oh, body. Body. Ground. One thing. More bodies. There we go. Letter from Witcher Colgrim of the Viper School to Ivar Evil Eye, Master Witcher of the Viper School. I have now found all the legendary diagrams once belonging to our order. Certain complications have arisen, however. On the way back to our keep, I stopped to rest a night in the village in the Temerian borderlands. The blasted peasants decided to make me into their scapegoat and accused me of kidnapping some beekeeper's brat. They took me into the local lordling's castle for interrogation, during which they found and confiscated one of the diagrams. But do not fear, I will get it back. They did not find the others. I have invoked Temerian common law and demanded a trial by ordeal instead of submitting to the whims of this baronet. My request was granted, and tomorrow I am to cleanse the baronet's family crypt of wraiths. I expect this will prove little trouble. Perhaps I will already have returned to our keep by the time you receive this letter. Light the furnaces. We'll have some forging to do. Ogrim. Now what level?
Magic. A place of power.
Brilliant, Geralt. You've already used that place of power. Thank you, Geralt, for the insight. What level craftsman do you think we need?
Strange.
Can anybody craft those? First tier. Don't remember. I watched S7 play some of The Witcher with the Polish audio. It does sound very good. Of course, I don't speak the language, so there's that. Perihelion's the lowest level craftsman, journeyman, will work. If we can, you can use the quartermaster at the Nilfgaard camp. Groovy, or maybe the guy in the village. Let's get that done. Need some blades. We'll just head south. See what we shall see. I just jump back to town real quick. Go all the way to the Nilfgaardian camp. I think the guy in town will do it. He only worked during the day. Not that it matters, we can change the time. Yeah, we'll see if I have the mats.
I think those plums are weakened out from
God. If I don't, we'll see if he does. Where does he work? Might have to wait until it's the right time of day anyways. About 9 a.m. See if he can work. Why aren't you using Roach? I will sometimes. I mean, why am I not using Roach all the time? Roach is an awesome horse that's frustrating to ride sometimes.
A return customer. Welcome. What can I do for you this time?
Like you to forge something for
oh,
me.
Oh, this one's just the armorer? Okay. We have, as long as we're here. Nothing.
So long.
Wait. But he's working on a sword. You're saying this guy's the armorer? But he's working on a sword. Well, where's our other guy? Oh, this is my favorite. This is my favorite. He's pulling feathers forever. There's an unlimited number of chickens in her basket. He'll just be plucking feathers. Ever and ever.
You chew him or swallow him whole.
Roach admits being frustrating. If you haven't seen the April Fool's Day Roach DLC video that CDPR put out, you gotta check it out. You gotta check it out. Okay, so let me look around town a little more because I don't remember where he's at. Chetty, don't want you hanging out with Chetty anymore. You're not to play with Chetty. Oh, he's just an armorer. There is no other smith here. that what's up? I'm going back to the quartermaster.
Freak.
Pretend I didn't hear that. These starter pants are a little too quilted for me. I need something else.
Make way.
Why choose both?
Decently, that is what you folk lack.
Would I rather play part of the game or part of the game? I'd rather play all of the game.
Or haggle.
Like you to craft something for me.
What are we missing? A little bit of silver? I might have something I can break down. All parts present. Anything extra here? Now we're also missing some emerald dust. 449 to buy. He doesn't actually have the silver. You can see the prompt here. This was patched into the game later. If the craftsman you're speaking with has the ingredients you need, and you don't, you have the option of buying them without having to go over to his shop. Two of them. I need one. It's 449. On the plus side, I can sell him a lot of the crap I have, and then if I just need to buy it, I can. Right. Sell everything. I put on the hunting trousers just because they look different. We'll get gear. Better. You just person called Temerian, yes. I did not make enough money to buy even one bit of emerald dust. Not even one. Not have the silver, right? Just iron. Anything else I can sell him? Caught it! No, I really don't. I really don't have anything else I can sell him. Well, that's one sword.
So long.
Can I dismantle Witcher swords for emerald? I am also not sure. We'll have money soon enough. And enough for that. We can just pop back and get it done. We've got the diagram. We can move on for now. Sword I can sell. Adrenaline point gain will eventually be my thing. 3% on top of the 2% I got bonus from. Maybe the occasional stun or stagger would be more useful. For now, just have something in there. Rudy, are you going to sleep? 4:30. Good night. Come say hey when you're up, if you feel like it. We'll be here. Thanks for joining us, too. We'll catch you next time, I hope. Shall we take that and go back and meet Vesemir? Why don't we do that? Let's do that. We got a couple diagrams. Soon enough, we'll have some levels and some food and all those good things.
The Emperor shall guide us straight to Novigrad.
Yankee, you're taking off too? Good night, good night. We'll see you later.
such a lush.
Silver ingot, emerald dust, or just a coin to buy it. And we're going to the inn. And he called Freak again. Well, we'll just pretend. Batteries around, but I think my controller batteries are getting a little weak.
Yennefer's in Vizima. Got a few friends there, so...
Hey, Willow. Here's the bubble baths.
Look around. Trouble brewing.
Why don't we go?
Time we were on our way.
Mm-hmm. I'll buy some provisions for the journey. Then we'll go. Geralt, we should stay out of it. Just this once.
Bad chance.
What happened to the lilies?
Took them down.
Took them down? To hang a golden sun there now?
I cannot show Temerian colors. They'll come and burn the tavern down.
Maybe it's true what they say. You fond of the Imperials? You Nilfgaard's whore?
I'll let that pass. I know grief eats at your heart.
You know shit. They hang my sister, dragged her out of the cloister like a dog. Said Nilfgaard's no place for superstition, that they don't fear the wrath of the gods. And you, do you fear it? If not for Annie, your child would have choked on its navel string. You owe your son to
Let
my sister
go.
Attending to the
no.
birth, and you don't fear the god's wrath. You don't fear it, you cunt! Leave me be!
Recognize this medallion? You know what it means. Back off.
You all right?
They say witches steal young'uns. That true? What the Emperor promise you, freaks? Your own land, like he did the elves once?
Get out, all of you.
We ain't going nowhere. And neither are you.
They won't back down now.
I can see that.
Ah, brilliant. Yay for new blades, though. Oh, and who's in half? Fighting indoors, close quarters, when you can't see anything.
It's all right. It's over.
That blood's
Leave
better.
Leave me be! Get away!
See his face! God save us!
Be gone, and don't ever come back.
So much for not getting involved. Come on, let's go.
That brawl? We didn't start it.
Looky, looky.
Excuses, excuses. You've not changed a bit.
Yen? How?
I received a report about a Witcher who'd appeared in White Orchard. I knew it was you, looking for me. I might have waited until you found me, but... well, you know me. Patience has never been my strong suit. It's... good to see you, Geralt. I'd even embrace you. Were you not covered in blood?
Sorry. Wasn't expecting to see you. To be honest, this isn't at all how I imagined we'd meet.
How did you imagine it?
He didn't imagine you'd have a Nilfgaardian escort. Don't get me wrong, Yennefer. I'm glad to see you. But I do think you owe us an explanation.
And I shall provide it. In Vizima. Ready your horses.
Alias, it's a deal.
We can talk here. Some charming orchards nearby. In bloom, even. So you almost can't smell the corpses.
A tempting proposition.
That's weird.
Sadly, I must say no. You see, someone awaits you in Vizima. Someone who doesn't like to be kept waiting. Emperor Emir Var Emrys. Or, to those on more intimate terms with him, the white flame dancing on the graves of his foes.
Doubt I number among that group. For as I remember, last time we saw each other, he wanted to kill me.
Well, now he wishes to make you an offer.
The kind one can't refuse?
I didn't. Though I could have.
Must have been a damn good offer then. Not many things you'd give up your freedom for, and even fewer people.
The sooner we set off, the sooner you'll find out.
What about you?
I'm going in the opposite direction. I somehow doubt the Emperor's invitation mentioned me. Besides, I've got things to do at Caremore, remember?
Yeah, I remember. Thanks for your help, Vesemir. See you soon.
How's your horse? Swift?
Can't complain. Why do you ask?
I'd like to be back behind some thick city walls as soon as possible. Knowing you, it was probably filthy.
Just the beginning.
Filthy.
But then?
Rise now!
This bard's tale begins near White Orchard, with my dear friend Geralt of Rivia seeking his lover of yore, the sorceress Yennefer. She'd eluded him for years, but now seemed just a few steps ahead. After many trials and tribulations, Geralt finally learned that Yen was in nearby Vizima.
Thank you.
looked like they were having fun. And I know Geralt was enjoying himself. Mm.
It must suffice.
Think of your cares if I'm clean.
The gentleman
okay,
will
there's a way to keep the towel, right? How do I keep the towel?
Or not at all.
Keep the towel.
The gentleman will be seated on the bergère.
The gentleman
will do nothing of the sort.
Chair.
Arr.
Tetwin, please shave the gentleman's sideburns to half an inch.
What's wrong with my beard? Always thought it added to my dignity.
It does. Yet it also detracts from your elegance. In Nilfgaard, we consider beards hard on the eyes. Especially beards infested with lice.
Been on the road a while. Fine, do your thing.
Tilt your head back, please, and sit still.
Taking the beard.
How goes it? Preparations for the audience proceeding as planned?
Yes, General. The gentleman will be more or less presentable.
Who's this guy? He a barber too?
No. Morvran Voris, commander of the Alba Division. Yennefer's escort. They were my men. All of them. Indeed, were. For none have returned to Vizima, have they? I truly wonder what happened on the road yesterday. Perhaps you could enlighten me. You have time. And a razor to your throat.
Your men died in battle, as soldiers tend to.
I see their fate does not trouble you, overly.
True, but I'm guessing the fate of those whose country they invaded didn't overly trouble them.
Nordlings, we can bathe you, shave you, and clothe you, but teaching you manners, that will be a challenge.
Nice meeting you too.
Done. Shall I shave him once more, against the grain?
No. He himself is very much against the grain. That's enough. Farewell, Witcher. Or rather, see you soon.
Good. Now the gentleman may dress. Sadly, I did not receive exact measurements. If the garments chafe, our tailor will adjust them.
Yes. Make sure to do that import again. And this wasn't on stream. The Assassins of Kings playthrough that was imported was done here last year. Too many people here to see it. Some of you were.
Where are my clothes?
Where they should have gone long ago, with the laundress. They will be returned to you after the audience, clean and starched. The gentleman will tell me once he has
nice
chosen
void.
An outfit.
Alright, so we're gonna drop the towel? We're gonna drop the towel? Wait, let's see, drop the towel. Rest. Boxers under the towel. That's a cheat. So, okay, there it is. In there. Let me see. Drop the towel on the floor, pick it up before leaving the area. That way you can keep it instead of taking it away from you. Not really a fan of any of these. So, I pick it up now, or I have to still wait until I've equipped the other clothes and they've made a stink out of it? Yeah, not enough. We have not had any real chances to play Gwent, just one game so far. We did turn the Gwent setting to hard, but we haven't had a chance to do anything with it. So, should I be picking this up right now? When would they take it away from me, I guess is the question. Take all the other clothes if you want to be able to sell them. Ah! Yeah. Yeah, yeah. There you go. Good point. Take them all. Take them all. Extra money. When would they take away the towel? Still wondering, because pick it up, loot everything. Yeah, yeah, the other clothes, but what about the towel? Remember, we're trying to keep the towel. We're trying to cheese it and bring the towel. So it's important. If I pick it up now and they take it away in a minute, I'm just, you know, I'll be reluctantly reloading the safe because I want the towel. Allie's saying pick it up now. You can always reload if they take it away. Black, I want that towel now. You know I'm not big on loading safes, but...
satisfy the gentleman.
A studded doublet and a sword on my back, that's what would satisfy me. But tough, when in Nilfgaard.
Yes.
It's a saying. So what now? Powder my nose?
No need. The gentleman's complexion is light enough. The gentleman is to stand before the ruler of the North and South. I must confirm that he knows how to bow.
I'm not some boor. I know how to bow.
Please, demonstrate. That, sir, is how you might bow to a whore on a street corner, not to the Emperor of Nilfgaard. Please watch. Leg extended, hand flat, head down, chin to chest. The gentleman will rehearse. Lacking fluidity and grace. But we've learned to expect less of Nordlings. Come with me.
Got it. Can't check. Inventory now blocked off.
The gentleman will address the Emperor only when asked to, and using the appropriate title.
Your Arch Magnificency.
I see the gentleman is in the mood for jests. I fear the Emperor might not share his disposition. Your Majesty will suffice. Spoken loudly, clearly, and with respect.
Imgrimi eb art kerzer. Dyfen aden in karn eb marvut. Emir var emreis.
Bow. Your Imperial Majesty.
Arer ep do orde.
Avelian namen, vatgan favot. So many months at Foltest Court, yet you still haven't mastered the basics of etiquette.
Know what they say? Can't teach an old wolf new tricks. Take it you didn't summon me to reminisce about the good old days, so...
Silence. My daughter Cirilla, she's returned. And she's in danger. The Wild Hunt pursues her. You will find her and bring her to me.
Are you sure? Ciri left, went far, far away.
Do you believe I'd drag you here in the middle of a war to discuss a rumor?
I think anyone can be wrong, even an emperor.
I had forgotten how insolent you can be. I haven't the time to convince you, nor the desire, in fact. Yennefer will do that after the audience.
How many men in your army? 20,000? 30? So why me?
You know why. Because she trusts you.
She trusts me, yes. So tell me why you're looking for her. Doubt it's about making up for all those lost years.
For reasons of state, as always. Enough of this banter. You will agree regardless. If for no other reason than because I shall pay you. More than you customarily receive for a contract. Considerably more.
Save your generosity for those whose homes your armies have raised. I'll do it for Ciri, not for your gold.
Your motives do not interest me. Only results. Yennefer will tell you the rest.
This audience would make a good vampire, don't you think? Doesn't he look like a vampire lord?
Take him to the sorceress.
Gentlemen, not understand. Did I not emphasize adequately that one must bow to the Emperor?
Oh, believe
Relax.
Me, you did.
Nothing happened.
To the gentleman, but I shall be punished.
How?
Please keep close and bother no one. We've had enough breaches of etiquette for one day. And it's past noon.
Oh, hello.
What?
The talk to, we can't win Gwent here right now, but we can play it later, can't we? Talk to me about the Gwent that's here. Can we even play it now? But we can't win it now. Right? It's one of the harder games.
Tanner,
isn't it?
We got of the Tanner's Guild.
A shit deck. And nothing right now.
I demand.
Calm down. The Emperor demands silence. Those who disturb face harsh punishment. No matter their verdict.
Please stay with
yes, Pen Esquire.
Greetings.
Hello.
Do you think it becoming to disturb a lady?
Hmm? Never mind that. Mind. No Witcher Nookie for you.
The gentleman will have time for a stroll later. Please stay with me.
You're making the Chamberlain sad. Yes.
Seen as far as Novigrad?
Yeah, and nay. Rad sleeten enect as tun as a sour and nay fire.
As a seed efsat, as finsa nain mathgergat, nain kofhutel an emp pavar.
Es frag, yes seed.
Duth, this is for atra as parasaf.
Wombat! We missed you, what's going on?
Ep to some.
Mind if I interrupt?
Why not join in instead?
We're discussing neutrality. How difficult it is to preserve.
Know a thing or two about that.
Care to explain?
Never changes. I try to stay out of things, stand aside. Then comes an urgent summons. And an offer I can't refuse. Enough about that. Mind if we change the subject? So, talk to the Emperor.
Why did he summon you?
So not even you know.
No. But I wager it's an ordinary witch's contract.
Some weirbubs.
Weirbubs.
See ya.
Soon, mind you.
Not in a hurry to see the sorceress.
The gentleman is not in a hurry at all. Could I maybe get an explicit?
The gentleman will have time for a stroll later.
explanation of the Gwent situation here. I don't think I've ever played Gwent in the courtyard. Who is it you play with? Is it Vorhis? Later? Who is it you play? When's the right time to play it? Is this the only time to play it? We don't have a deck for it. Should we play it now? Gwent is set to Harn. I don't know. I'm filled with questions, but the answer would have to be in context for me to do anything with it, so. As Seven says, don't bail on, you can't bail on Gwent in the courtyard. Groovy, what are we talking about? Where's the Gwent in the courtyard? Just follow the Chamberlain. There's no expiring offer. Thank you. That's what I was looking for. Appreciate it.
Nintamir Deitra.
You got the salted caramel on that.
He should see me to retrieve his possessions.
Okie dokie. Perihelion saying no expiring offer. S7 saying, you play now, you big puss peepers. That's to say, right before you leave. After you talk to Yen, you can go to the courtyard and see a dude with a quest marker. Well, playing with our awesome deck.
Yes, then transcribe. The true authority in Novigrad is not the city council or the merchant's guild, but the Church of the Eternal Fire and the criminal underworld.
Eternal Fire! At times it is difficult to tell
the one from the other. They both display a similar ruthlessness and cynicism that...
Please wait, Your Excellency. I'm falling behind.
You know what? I'll write the report myself. You'll need only prepare a clean draft. In triplicate.
A shame I have no time.
So many books and papers to pick up here, too. Because it's a 24-hour stream, my voice will deteriorate anyways. I would like to keep reading things. I am not going to read everything we pick up in this room. If you see me pick up any of your favorites, let me know, and we can read them. They're good. It's good. Read it all. I encourage you to read it all. We've read through a great deal of it on stream, and we will read more. We will read
Geralt,
more tonight, but...
that tunic.
Can't read it all.
Positively smashing.
Ugh, dying to take it off.
I'd consider that a proposition under different circumstances. One I might even take you up on. But we've matters to attend to. Now do you understand why I'm at Emir's court?
Mm-hmm. And seems we're in the same boat now. Ciri, she's really back? No chance he's mistaken?
Look, that's more or less what she looks like now. Or so our agents claim.
Or less.
Our little witch has grown into a young lady.
How about that? She's grown up.
It's been years since you trained together at Kaer Morhen. A great deal has changed.
You haven't. Not a bit.
I missed those awkward compliments of yours. But let's focus on Ciri, all right?
Right. Emir said the Wild Hunt's after her. I'd find that hard to believe before what happened yesterday. How did they track us down?
Because of me. You see, I've spent months searching for Ciri. Using locating spells, haruspicy, geomancy, anything, really. I knew the Wild Hunt might sense it, perhaps even find me, but... I thought I'd tricked them.
Well, guess you were wrong.
I've sensed them on my trail, hunting me, for some time. If not for you and Emir's soldiers, they'd have gotten what they were after. I can't risk another encounter like that. It's time to put away the magic, turn to more traditional methods. To the best tracker I know. You must find her, Geralt.
Maybe a little.
Before the Wild Hunt does.
The Wild Hunt? What could it want from Ciri?
I've no clue, Geralt. Might have written them to ask, but I don't have their address. I know as much as you do. It must be about her blood. Her gift. As for what the Hunt wishes to do with that gift, I'd prefer not to think about it, really.
So where's Ciri been seen, exactly?
In two places. Velen and Novigrad. The trail in Velen is most promising. You should make that your first stop. Ask for a merchant named Hendrik at the inn at the crossroads. One of the Emperor's agents. He should get in touch with you.
That's it? No passwords? Secret handshakes?
None. Sorry to spoil your fun. Your boyhood fantasies about the crafts of the trade. All we have in Novigrad are unconfirmed reports, rumors. But there you will have the help of our mutual acquaintance. Triss Merigold. Apparently she's got a cozy flat on the main square.
Sure she'll be delighted to see me. What about you? What will you do?
I shall sail for Skellige. There was a magic explosion there recently, blew half a forest down. I believe this had something to do with Ciri. I'll be in Caer Trold. Join me there once you've learned something.
One thing before we go. Why didn't you contact me? Didn't need me? Didn't even want to see me?
I didn't want to spoil things. I'd heard you and Triss made a great couple.
Yen, I'd lost my memory.
Really? That's your excuse?
Pretty good excuse.
Let's drop it, all right? It's not what you think, or it helped me understand how much I love you. I don't wish to hear it. Any of it.
Yeah, I wasn't gonna say it.
Guess this means we need to split up again. Not my preference, but I understand. Clock's ticking.
It is indeed. So why don't I teleport you to Vel and get you there at once?
Not gonna happen. I'll go on horseback, as soon as I can get changed.
Have it your way? Oh, and you really look quite dashing in black velvet.
Think so? Maybe I can have some of my armor lined with it. Good luck, Yen.
Same to you. And if you wish to learn what's happened in the world while you and Vesemir roam the wilderness, talk to Ambassador Vaartra. That's him over there. And Geralt, I know it's wartime, but try not to be a hero, all right? Just check those leads and come back to me, in one piece. I shall be waiting.
A lot of books. Whoosh! She gone. Gee, who knows? That might be one we need to read, is it? This one's worth reading right now. It'll come up later. Oak say there were four at first. The mother, she who knows, the lady of the wood, came here from a faraway land, and since she suffered terribly from loneliness, she made three daughters out of dirt and water. A long, long time ago, the mother was the sole ruler of all Valen. Her daughters brought her the people's requests and served as her voice. Each spring, sacrifices of grain, animals, and men were made to the Lady of the Wood on her special night. Yet as the years passed, the Lady of the Wood slipped deeper and deeper into madness. Her madness eventually spread over the land. Men took to abandoning their homes and setting out into the bog where they became food for beasts. Before long, Valen was drowning in blood. The daughters saw their land nearing destruction and took it upon themselves to save it. When spring came once more, and with it the night of sacrifices, they killed their mother and buried her in the bog. Her blood watered the oak atop Ard Serbin, and from there on the tree grew wholesome and hearty fruit for the people. As for the lady's immortal soul, it refused to leave its beloved land, and so the sisters imprisoned it. To this day it lies trapped beneath the whispering hillock, where it thrashes about. Powerless rage. Still can't access inventory, but we can pick things up. Royal Lineages of the North. Again, we'd spend a lot of time reading and it would work towards ruining my voice for the rest of the long stream if I read everything. A bit about Cirilla, Fiona, Ellen, Rhiannon. But if you see me pick up something that you don't want to miss, let me know. Sword for witches. Who are the hunters, you ask? Ooh, rusty bread knife. Been looking for that all day. Wild hunt. Relevant.
I am assuming direct control.
Just a test. Best quote ever. Nice, you hit zero. Way to roll a zero, dude. Way to roll a zero. Welcome, Woo. What's up, man? From farmers and herdsmen, milkmaids to midwives, all the common folk of the continent whisper, sharing tales of a wraithly procession pounding across the sky. The wild hunt, they call it. Winds and gales, storms and blizzards arise when it is sighted, and all grows cold, though the sun shone bright moments before. Some remember only the cold from the shock of the encounter, and claim the riders come always in winter. But nay, this is not so. The hunt brings its own ice. Death and war gallop in its wake, or so the superstition goes. Yet evil enough is the hunt itself. It takes folk captive, youths most often, in the prime of their wilding years, with 10 to 20 summers behind them. The hunt rushes in and they disappear, only to return long years later with no memory of what passed in the time between. Letter to Yennefer. Oh, I gotta read that. I resign myself to reading a lot of this. Yennefer, my dear friend, thank you for your letter. Forgive me for not answering your earlier attempt to reach me via Megascope. I'm trying to limit my magic communication to the absolute minimum. One never knows who's listening, don't you agree? I'm delighted you have found a position at our gracious Emperor's court and wish you the best of luck in the search for his daughter. It's good to know that Amir's intentions for her have become more, how shall I put it, mundane. Perhaps in these circumstances, an agreement regarding the lodge will prove
message
possible after all.
Patching it through.
Oi, Chi, thank you for the host. In response to your first question, I can state beyond all doubt that Ciri has not appeared anywhere south of the Yoruga. Believe me, I could recognize her magic signature in my sleep. I have not had any contact with Triss for a long time. I only know that things in Novigrad have taken an ill turn. She mentioned something earlier about fleeing to Kovir. I'm afraid that in the current political climate, that amounts to an impossible daydream. I hope I will soon be able to join you in Vizima. First, however, I must take care of some unfortunate yet urgent matters in Beauclair. With my fondest regards, Fringilla Vigo. P.S. Thank you for the news about Geralt. He always seems to land on his feet, doesn't he? It's all right. Ah, Cirilla, Fiona, Ellen, Rhiannon. Collected verse of Gonzalo de Verceo. Love. Love is to build a house of cards, or play a game of chess. But one wrong word or ill-thought move, you must start it all afresh. Whenever I watch the tide recede, old coils of fear grip round my heart. Will the seas sneak back calm and sure in the dark of night as they have before? Or will they stay on distant shores, giving crushed shells and washed-up dreams as memory of serfs of. Last wish. This stuff is all so relevant. We just can't skip through all this stuff. It's way too relevant. The Last Wish. Last Wish. I have not read the Witcher novels, and I know many of you have. Maybe one day I will. I would like to. You know, I don't even find time to watch other streams, let alone read fantastic series of novels. Hey, Tails. The Last Wish. Human life requires three things for its sustenance: food, drink, and gossip. It is thus no wonder that no matter where I travel, be it Icebound, Povis, or Evergreen Toussaint, everyone asks me about the passions that bind Geralt and the sorceress Yennefer of Vengerberg. As a man both cautious and discreet, I refuse to betray their secrets, with one important exception. The history of their first encounter is so extraordinary, so romantic and moving, that it would be a veritable crime to hide its light beneath a bushel basket. Indeed, had I not witnessed these events in person, I would never believe there was room in our grim and dark world for such fantastic marvels. It all began when Geralt and I were feeling a bit peckish and, unburdened by heavy coin pouches, decided to fish our supper out of a lake. No bites were to be had, but we did not leave empty-handed. My hook snagged quite a lovely little pot. Oblivious to my friend's warnings, I opened it, and in doing so freed a powerful djinn. Without giving it much thought, I set about proclaiming my wishes. Before I could get to three, however, the djinn, irritated, I see now in hindsight, at being issued demands so soon after waking, began to throttle me. Geralt was able to drive him off, but I was left in a sorry state. I acted, the Witcher told me later, as though under the influence of some curse. Clearly, the help of an expert in magic arcana would be needed. It was our good fortune that Yennefer of Vengerberg happened to be staying in a nearby village. Geralt went to her to ask that she heal his best friend, who happened to also be the brightest star in the North's poetic firmament. Yennefer, however, was more interested in the djinn, which she wanted to trap into magic servitude, than its victim, and, it should be said, played the Witcher like a well-strung mandolin. She played him like a damn fiddle! Yet rather than grow angry at being used in such a calculating manner, he fell white, head over muddy boots, in love with her. What happened then? Well, I won't go into details. Suffice to say that Yennefer's plans hardly delighted the djinn, and without its cooperation, she proved unable to tame it. The sorceress would surely have met a tragic end, and taken all of Rind along with her, had Geralt not rushed to her rescue. For once, he did not need to draw either of his blades. To send the djinn packing, he had but to pronounce the third and final wish. He could have asked for anything, wealth, fame, power, but instead he asked the djinn to bind his fate to that of the arrogant yet intriguing sorceress from Vengerberg. Julian Alfred Pancratz, Viscount of Lettenhove, born 1232, award-winning poet, playwright, and troubadour, frequent performer at the courts of Nidamir, Vizimir, Venslav, and many other nobles and notables. Alumnus of Oxenfurt Academy. I'm gonna try not to read everything else I pick up. Please don't all be so relevant. Sword for Witches. Didn't we already pick up the same book a moment ago? Quick! Let's leave before we find more books!
Directly out of Northern...
Ambassador Varatra, Yennefer suggested I ask you about current events, the war and so on.
Of course. The Emperor's servants should keep no secrets from each other. If you will, let us approach the map.
How's the war going? I mean, apart from the fact that Nilfgaard's triumph is imminent.
I assume this to be a private conversation. We've no witnesses, so let's dispense with the propaganda.
Message coming in.
Shrouded in irony.
Patching it through.
The offensive was going splendidly until winter came. Edirne was in such disarray that we encountered no resistance. We had reached the Pontar before the first snows. Only a weakened Kedwin remained. And Radovitz Redania, which ignored the rest of the North's pleas for help. We thought they'd sue for peace. Perhaps even submit to vassalization. We waited for spring, certain of victory.
Radovid? Submit?
Yes, a vain hope, I agree. Radovid sent no peace envoy, nor did he advance on our positions. Instead, he trudged over the snow-bound Kestrel Mountains and attacked Kedwin, his ally. Took the Kedweni completely by surprise. King Henselt fought on the front line as always, and that is where he died. His soldiers lost the will to fight. They joined Radovid's ranks. And so by spring, instead of two weak enemies, we had only one powerful one.
What about Kavir?
Kavir values its neutrality. Enough not to lend its armies, or more importantly, even its coin to either side. Returning to the war, this spring there was a massive battle in the marshes of Velen. Massive, yet indecisive. Both sides suffered enormous losses, unprecedented even. Radovid has retreated across the Pontar. He's safe for now, until reinforcements arrive from the south. Then Emperor Emir Var Emrys will deal with him once and for all.
Couldn't you just go home? Save everyone a lot of marching, not to mention a few human lives.
I'm afraid the stakes are too high to fold now. We can only go all in.
How do things look in Velen?
As bad as ever. Perhaps worse. This land never flowed with milk and honey, and now it flows with blood. Armies have swept through it several times, trampling fields, looting granaries, burning villages. Famine grips the populace.
So how's ruling that earthly paradise going for you?
Not well, to be honest. Our forces are spread thin as it is, and Velen is chiefly swampy forests that are difficult to control. We've had several patrols never return to their camps. Thus, we've temporarily delegated authority in this region to a certain Nordling, a former low-ranking officer in the Temerian army, one Philip Strenger, better known by his nom de guerre, the Bloody Baron. I advise you well, avoid him.
Well, we'll see.
Any news from Novigrad? Is the Free City still free?
Yes, although everyone knows this won't last. Radovid is in Oxenford, and the Emperor is here in Vizima, at Novigrad's doorstep, both. And both require coin and ships. Novigrad can provide these. Which is why the mood in the city is rather, well, on edge.
Meaning?
How do men deal with fear? They seek reassurance. And scapegoats. The Church of the Eternal Fire understands this perfectly, and so it promises to improve the lives of its flock by pointing out the guilty. Who started the war? Who profits from it? Why, it's obvious. Mages, elves, dwarves, in a word, any and all deviants. I've been stationed in Novigrad for 13 years. First as a consul, then as ambassador. I've seen a great deal. Cruelty, cynicism, greed. But what is happening there now concerns me greatly.
What's new in Skellige?
Nothing. The islanders pride themselves on that, don't they? Doing everything according to tradition, as their forefathers did. And like their forefathers, they quarrel with each other, pillage, occasionally attack our transports. This is cumbersome, but nothing more.
Skellige has always been a footnote to history, and so it shall remain.
Sound awfully confident. What if King Bran manages to unite the Jarls? Lead all the clans against your fleet?
King Bran is a feeble old man. From what I know, he barely remembers the names of his own vassals. Uniting all might prove difficult.
Thanks for your help.
Think nothing of it. May the great sun light your path.
I know it's a lot to absorb, but if you're not already familiar with it, that's a lot to take in. I'm sure I would do a poor job of trying to recap or elaborate on what he was talking about. The situation with the different powers that be in the lands, the battles that are being waged. He was talking about the powers that be and where they are presently. And a lot of that will come up. We'll go see the Bloody Baron, Radovid, become of Temeria, Earls of the North.
Might I serve the gentleman?
By returning my things.
Citrus and cloves. The fragrance will keep the gentleman's robes fresh somewhat longer.
Thanks, Bunches.
Bunches. Thanks, Bunches.
The Emperor is not known for his patience. He wants his daughter back safe and sound, as soon as possible.
Yeah, mentioned something of the sort.
So getting our ass kicked at Gwent time. I may have finally learned how to play Gwent, and I may have even learned a few tricks that I can occasionally put to use. But, this is the start of a new game. We have a terrible deck. We've got nothing to play with. Yeah, we'll do it. Good times. There's our game of Gwent. I see the deck before we dive in. You can just get in a minute. We do not have cards for anything but the Northern Realms deck right now. Look, we've got 6 cards for Nilfgaard, 6 cards for Scoia'tael, 6 cards for monsters, nothing. So, Northern Realms, the deck at the moment, 1 Deep Boy, Biting Frost, Zoltan! Catapult, we don't even have a matched catapult. I mean, it's a starter deck. We've got nothing. And Gwent is on hard. So this should be interesting. Let's have fun with it. This is a one-off, right? Well, here's the thing. If and when I lose, I know you'll want me to reload. That's so not the plan. Who plays Gwent? Who's the Gwent player? Not you. You.
Gwent, play me.
Wouldn't mind a few rounds of cards.
Should have changed my clothes already. Taking off the hoity-toities. So, yay. All right, Nilfgaardian Empire with, man, I don't even recognize that version of the Emperor Leader card. At least we get Gwent music. Can't fail that part. Music always wins. Catapult, nothing to pair it with. At least a trebuchet. Death Mold. Bicard, good. Gila de Tancerville. Her silly hat. Not like I've got better cards to pull out of the deck. I could get a second one, that would be nice. Frost, try and get something better. Hey, it worked! We got another commando. Okay, maybe redraw the plus one, yeah. So I redrew the siege. Look at that, I got lucky. That was lucky as hell. I don't have a lot of stuff in my deck. I only have two of those. I don't think I have three. So that was a pretty lucky draw. That was exactly why I redrew the Frost card. Was hoping, just hoping, I would get that. Because these will work together and double the other strength. They will both be eights instead of fours. They don't get ruined. Now what is... Look at three random cards from your opponent's hand. So Gwent is already set on hard. I suppose if he plays that and gets to look at the cards from my hand, three random cards, that will somehow increase his aptitude for the round if he knows what is there. AI will play a little differently. So, first round, no reason not to throw spies out. You can always throw the first round. Sometimes you want to, sometimes you need to. But throw out those spies early. It's certainly a popular strategy. It's not the only way to go. Spy goes to the enemy's points. Did you get extra cards? I did have a third commando! Oh, I did have a third commando. Look at that. Your opponent has passed. Normally, I don't know, normally that wouldn't happen. He passed early. He just handed me the first round. That's... We just got handed the first round. I can play a flat six and win this round. He didn't even decoy the spy or anything. I don't know. Somebody played... Did somebody pray to RNGesus? Did somebody? That's cool. I'm just thinking about the ranks before I play this. I might want to... I could play the trebuchet. Take the first round cheap win. Yes, I'm going to. Then draw out as many of his cards in the second round to make the third easy. I will keep that in mind in terms of which to play, just in case something... I do have a Sunny Day Foltest who can clear up a weather card. But not knowing what weather cards might show up. Having a split between ranged and siege. Anyways, I'm overthinking it. We got an easy win on this round. Take it. Won the round. Northern Realms faction ability. We get an extra card drawn from the deck, like Skaggs. Elden Skaggs. I was there on the front lines, right where the fighting was the thickest. So we want to draw him out, maybe? Well, play some low points and see what we can do. We'll see what he plays before we decide on that. If we win this round, game's over. But if we go all out to win this round and we get stomped and don't have much left to play, Nilfgaard can pull out some surprises like that, especially if he's got spies. I do have a decoy. If he plays a spy this round, I'm grabbing it. Hey, good morning, KG. Welcome back. Zoltan. Frost. I could clear that frost. But... Slugger! What's up, Slugger? Play Vess. Better to live one day as a king than a whole life as a beggar. I'm gonna play Vess into the frost, then we'll see what he does. I can always clear up that weather if I need those points, if I decide I want those points. But for now, let's see if we can draw him out a little bit more. Now, he just got a peek at the cards, three cards, which means strategically he may make different moves than if he hadn't played that leader. In the meantime, that was a great way for him to pass the ball back to me. Oh, KG's getting her new PC today. That is very exciting. I know more exciting for you than it is for the rest of us, but it's kind of exciting here too. I know you're gonna be so happy to play things again, not have blue screen crashes, be able to stream again. Everybody keep an eye out for KG Fanatic when she's streaming again. New PC coming today. And as for Gwent, Deathmold, go! Letho! Played a hero into the frost. I'm tempted to play Sunny Day Foltest. We need to keep enough cards to win the third round if we're gonna lose this one. I'm prepared to lose this round. We win this round, we win the game, but... Nilfgaard deck. Nilfgaard deck. So let's clear up that weather. Gamble on him not playing another weather card later. We'll just have to keep an eye on it. We might be able to win the game in this round. Possible. See, I'm saving these. Maybe it's silly at this point. What do we want to try and win the third round with? What do I want to save for that third round? I've had my eye on the commandos because they can multiply each other's damage and actually be quite a powerful play to have the three of them. So he's got four cards. Very possibly a spy in there, which will give him two more cards. Spy of questionable point value. I would add to my total, but then he gets more cards. So it looks like I have a one card advantage. A one card advantage on a Nilfgaard deck. One of my cards is a decoy, and I don't really know what he's gonna play. Let's say I play the, is this a trebuchet catapult? Let's say I play the catapult. He might or might not play another card. He probably will. And it'll be three cards versus three cards and all of that decoy. I could decoy back one of the cards I'm playing now for the points in the next round. But if he plays a spy that's not a hero card, the spy will be on my side of the board and I can use the decoy to snatch it. And then I can play the spy for more cards. Let's see. Perihelions is saying if it's down to three, the three infantry will beat anything he possibly has unless it's all spies. So I need to save those three is what I've been eyeballing. You could play the eight siege and then decoy it. That was just, you know, it's cool. I'm actually thinking along those lines. I hadn't read what you said before running my mouth about it. Alternatively, you could conservatively save the decoy in case of spies in round three. Exactly. Well, it's cool. We're on the same page at the moment. Let's play the catapult, which will not bring us up over his points, but might force him to. Oh, look at this. At least we teased. That would have ruined! Did you think of that, Perihelions? Third round, that would have wrecked us, because I already used Sunny Day Foltest. That he just played that frost card right now might have won the game. We might have won because he played that frost card now. We almost certainly would have lost if I saved those guys and he played it later. Looky, looky, looky. Go conservative and Umi's got a spy. Pass the round. I did. If he has another frost card, we're just as screwed, though. What do you think the odds are? Oh, he just burnt his Scorch, and we still have two. Think of all the ways he could have wrecked us. He had saved that Scorch. I think we won, though. I think. Who's your daddy? That's what's up. Oh, hell yeah. Boltist! Very good, sir. Good game. Foltest. Did we get the Foltest he was playing? Not... That actually might... I've never played that Foltest. that a good one to play?
Excellent!
Got a different foltus. This one doubles the strength of all your siege units, unless a commander's horn is also present in the row. Basically a specialized commander's horn. I'm gonna keep Sunny Day for now.
Yes! Booyah!
I saw you.
Well, I didn't expect to win that. I'm stoked. I guess if we can pull that off with a crap deck and Gwen's on hard, we got a chance! Do you know what time it is? Some of you probably know what time it is. It's actually break time. Oh, let's see. I'll be taking about a 12-minute break, 24-hour stream. Breaks are always important, but they're even more important during these streams. So I think I've got it right. The first chunk of the stream turned out to be 3 hours instead of two, but I'm trying to get back on my two hours. Go stretch my legs. That is the best leader card. You like the Siege Doubler, Crash? So we're coming up on 9 hours. 24-hour stream. We're going to be here for a while. Go stretch your legs and come back. If you're taking off, have a good one. Just know, we're not going anywhere. And I will be back in about 15. Did I say 10? 12? 15? Somewhere in there. Haven't picked the songs yet. See you soon.